Man, was this a move they needed to make. I feel like a weight has been lifted now. Steve Mills, for all people say, good guy, people liked him, put all that aside. This was not a basketball guy who was making incredibly important basketball decisions as the president of the franchise.
Yeah, how'd it go?
And it went terribly. He had two stints with the Knicks, actually, and both of them ended poorly. First one was back in 2007, court cases, things like that. We all know what happened there.
Well, he's the one that led Dolan Isaiah. He originally made that introduction. Now, listen,
now he's out again.
And now he's out. He's out as Knicks president. The interesting thing is that Perry remains for the foreseeable future, or for right now. He's going to remain as general manager. And Woj came out with another report saying the Knicks are going to target Toronto Raptors. President GM Masai Ujiri is going to be the target of James Dolan here, who's under contract, as you mentioned, through 2020, 2021. It comes back to the discussion we had earlier in the season. You could not have Perry and Mills making decisions about this team's future, or Mills making a decision about this team's future, trading assets, trading young players, if you did not believe or he was going to conceivably be out after the end of the season. Now, when we were talking about it at 10 o'clock when we hopped on the airwaves, no one had any idea that Mills, 2 hours later, was going to be out of a job as president of the Knicks. That was the problem with all these discussions, whether it be with the Hornets about Rozier and Malik Monk, whether it be with the Golden State Warriors and D'Angelo Russell, when you're talking about trading first-round draft choices, maybe, conceivably. The problem you have when you're trading assets, and specifically young assets, you have to make sure your decision makers for the long term are in place. And that was the problem with this team. I don't love Perry remaining here as general manager, because I don't know if that's the case where, you know, he could easily be out of the job after the season, but you understand why Mills loses his job and he had to go.
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, Mills was definitely one of the problems here. And there was no reason that he should have been back after the first time when he left the franchise back in 2014. This is already good news enough. This is good news that Steve Mills is no longer going to be, you know, the president of basketball here for the Knicks. It's about time they had to turn things around. And this is how you start, right? When you talk about the yes men that are around Dolan, or you talk about the people who are standing in the way of this franchise and being successful, that one of those people is squarely Steve Mills. I mean, you cannot overstate it.